Atomic annihilation, the rebuilding of this great nation of ours may fall to you. That's why we at Vault-Tec have prepared these educational materials for you to better understand the seven defining attributes that make you special. Our topic today is endurance. We will all be faced with many new and unfamiliar health risks, such as infection, sudden loss of limb, and above all, harmful radiation. Fortunately, your formidable endurance has turned your body into a hard-working machine that can resist the harmful effects of radiation and physical violence. Like any machine, then, your body must be well-maintained to stay in tip-top shape. While average Joes will survive on old packaged standbys, your ironclad insides will allow you to seek fresh meat. Radiation poisoning may have enlarged your favorite meals. This means more healthful nutrition for you. Take caution not to bite off more than you can chew. Endurance can also provide new options for food, some of which can be an acquired taste. Gone are the days of exercising for fun. Instead, you will need to combine athletics with crucial survival activities. The greater your endurance, the further you can go. Just be certain to be mindful of others. Build your endurance, and soon you will find ways that it improves your life above ground. Of added confidence in the swimming pool, stronger, more resilient limbs to the flesh of your fellow man can provide. Regularly study your Vault-Tec provided materials to prepare for survival and to answer the question, do you know what makes you special?
What the fuck was that?
What?
having fun. No sign of him now.
Someone there?
Peek-a-boo!
Come on out. I'll make it nice and cool. You can trust me.
Ain't personal. Just you or me.
Let's not keep Eddie waiting.
Thank you. sweet. That's it.
Keep it clean, Boston. Please dispose of food waste in the marked receptacles.
Lights out for you!
Someone's coming.
Hey, that's
in the event of an emergency.
Got it. Nick.
I never would have made it this far without you. That filthy toad's right on the other side of that door. Why don't you do the honor?
Sure. 195-3728-406.
Who the fuck are you?
Oh, come on, Eddie! It's me! Your old pal, Molly McFuck yourself!
All this time, and the first person to walk through my door is a wise ass. Well, you are easy on the eye, so that's something. Just how the fuck did you get? No. No way. Not after all this time. Don't tell me you actually cracked my code. In the holotapes? Well, hey, it's only been, what, 200 years? Well, look, I'm not sure what you thought you'd find. Gold, jewels, the secrets of the universe. But you get me. One guy. A ghoul, I guess you'd call me. Just living, surviving, and what I got, you can't have. That code? It was a joke. I just wanted to prove how dumb those feds were. Turns out, pretty dumb. So take your asses someplace else.
I'm not going anywhere until I get what I came for.
Yeah? And what's that? And who are you, huh? You look kind of familiar. But what are you, some kind of robot? Is that what it's like out there now? A world of robot overlords? I knew it.
The name's Valentine. Nick Valentine. Remember me?
Valentine? The cop? Is that who you're supposed to be? Sorry, pal, but you ain't Nick Valentine. You're just some kind of, machine.
You killed my fiance, Jennifer Lanz. There's some crimes even you can't get away with, Winter.
Your fiance? You mean Valentine's fiance. Pretty girl. A shame what happened to her. But hey, you? Or, you know, the real Valentine? He should have backed off when he had the chance. But what gives, Robot Man? Why do you even care? Some girl gets whacked 200 years ago, and you come into my home acting like a hard guy? Christ, look at you. You're not even alive.
Then I guess I'm in good company.
You ain't taking me down! Shit! Not yet.
You're done here. One more thing I've got to do. I wouldn't mind the company if you wanted to tag along.
Perfect.
Security's
too
good. So I guess building that shelter was a smart idea after all, huh?
this is it. In this spot, 200 years ago, one of Eddie's boys put a bullet in Jenny Land's back. Now Eddie's as dead as Jenny and Nick. I'm at a loss. All I know is that without you, Eddie'd still be at large.
Taking down Winter was a big deal. Are you doing all right?
I don't know. It's a lot to take in. Winter was it. The only reminder left of the original Nick Valentine. The last proof outside of some long-lost Institute archive I was ever just a mechanical copy of some cop from a bygone era. I'm not sure how to feel.
Does it really matter? Winter, Jenny, Valentine, they're gone. We're here. We get to make the world what we want.
You're right. It just took me until now to realize it. Because I was Nick Valentine. I had his memories, his fears, all that poor bastard's hope. I remember getting the call to head to some lab in Cambridge to get that neurotrans whatever. And the next thing I know, I'm in a trash heap. My family, my home, my entire life, gone. Then I discover all those things that they weren't even mine. Everything I ever was belonged to Nick. I'd hoped with Winter gone, the last hint of that old world snuffed out, I could finally be free. But being out here with you, what I finally realized after all this time was that taking down Winter, it wasn't about Nick or Jenny or even you or me. It was about justice. About doing what's right. And that act of goodness, that's ours. All the good we've done, that's ours. And ours alone. And even if that's the only thing in this world that I can ever claim as mine, not Nick's, not the Institute's, but mine, then I can die happy.
And none of it would have ever happened if it weren't for you. I'm not sure I'll ever be able to thank you for that.
You don't have to, Nick. We're friends. This is what friends do.
You can't stop being noble now, can you? Well, come on then. We're not helping anyone standing around here. Yeah, that is if you're still interested in traveling together. I wouldn't blame you if you wanted some time on your own after all this.
Of course. Let's do it.
I'm glad to hear it. Come on, let's get out of here.
Thank you.
Seems to be growing well.
We're in some real trouble here. I hope you can help.
Let's trade some things.
Okay.
Some diagnostics by your tinkering. Take your time. Hello? What are you hiding?
Hey, come look at this.
Me, freedom's always worth fighting for. Hope this rain lets me see.
Sorry, I wouldn't be very good company right now. I know I'm not the only person here. I just...
got a dangerous look about you. Hope you ain't here for me.
I'd like to trade some items.
Sure. I don't know what we're going to do.
Our little sanctuary revival project has really helped. I think my mind off things.
Thank you. nothing out of the Commonwealth yet.
No accounting for taste.
Thank you.
is not an easy place to travel alone. It's nice to have someone watching my back.
I hope you realize how much you did for us.
Why not discover anything you might miss?
And I should know.
Deacon, is that you?
Like the disguise? It's Wastelander camo. This is my pile of garbage, asshole. Back off. Good, right? You're lucky I didn't do one of my face swaps, too.
You can change your face.
I put myself under the knife every year or two. New face, new body, you know, the full makeover. It keeps our enemies guessing.
I almost didn't recognize you.
That's the point. So, about the job. The railroad's only recently been using the old North Church. Our old base was underneath the Slocum's Joe. We had a pretty sweet setup until the Institute found us.
Tough break.
And then some. The survivors didn't have time to grab anything. So we're getting something important we leave behind.
Go on.
We got a tourist nearby. He or she has information on the base. So let's pump him for information before we dive in. For now, I'll take the point. So I'm looking for rail signs. Symbols we use to send messages. If you like that, we've got signs and counter signs, dead drops, even a secret handshake. Alright, play the handshake card got on. Anyway, the tourist should have a trail left for us. Here we go. Rail sign. The arrow in the center indicates a direction. So our tourist is up ahead. Let's keep going. Another. We're probably close. Us in the center, that means there's an ally nearby, our tourist. You take point on the conversation. Look, no matter what he says, you just say, mine is in the shop. Trust me.
You have a Geiger counter? Do you have a goddamn Geiger counter?
Mine is in the shop.
Who the hell is he? HQ said they were sending one agent, not two.
Sorry, I'm new. She's just showing me the ropes.
All right. The wall is my witness. I thought I was dead. It's about goddamn time you headquarters bastards got here.
Tell me what's going on.
I signed on for some light recon. but that little Slocum's Joe of yours is crawling with goddamn chrome dome synth sons of bitches! The front's fortified to hell and back. They place mines all over the goddamn place.
I appreciate all you've done.
I hope it helps. I really do. As soon as it's safe, I'm getting the hell out of here. So if you need anything else, better ask soon.
Hey.
Well, isn't Ricky just a ray of sunshine? You think he's telling the truth?
Speaking of truth, why did you lie to Ricky?
My job in the railroad is intel. That job's easier if no one knows who I am. So, I lied. I do that. So you handled the talky-talk, and I got to watch from the sidelines. Go team us.
He's probably telling the truth. But you never know.
I agree. Odds are good we can take him at face value. First rule in this business is never go against your gut. So if we take him at his word, the front door has mines, synths, and probably other fun and exciting prizes. So we're going in through the escape tunnel.
The tunnel has got to be easier than a frontal assault.
Easier, but no cakewalk. You lead us there, pal. I got you covered.
Hey.
I'm all ears.
Hey, Valentine.
Got something for me?
Back entrance is safer, but be ready for Gen 1s and 2s. So it's time you learn why we're here. We're retrieving a prototype developed by our good Dr. Carrington.
What can you tell me about the Gen 1s and 2s?
The synths didn't start off as nigh-perfect copies of human beings. The Institute had to work up to that level of hubris. Gen 1s and 2s were stepping stones along the way. The railroad's not fully united on how we feel about him.
Who's Dr. Carrington?
All goes well. You'll meet him soon enough.
What's there to be divided about?
Everyone wants to liberate the Gen 3s, the human-looking synths. Some of the synths in the railroad, like Glory, think we should help earlier models, too. But Gen 1s are basically the same as, well, a Protectron, so the line gets muddy. Do we defend AI rights? Terminals? Hell, turrets? Anytime it gets brought up, fireworks. All the old arguments flare up. The upshot is Glory and some others won't run missions like this.
Ready to go.
First step is to override the security lockdown.
Got a pretty good track record cracking.
Well, the terminal's on at least. I'm gonna feed it some passwords.
No. Missed one, you cocky bastards. Prototype's deeper inside. Someone left a rail sign here. This one is dead.
Enemy. Operating at full capacity. All systems nominal. Engaging hostile life form.
Like Maven managed to hide something before.
Go on.
Look around. Tinker managed to turn on the defenses. Barely slowed the coursers down, but hey, probably saved some lives.
I am equipped with the most advanced Institute sensors available. Excellent. I will find you. Terminated.
Protect something, huh? Precious.
time to trip the defenses up ahead. Power them up, and we can give our friends a little surprise.
Nice.
Bajet ones. Prepare to be shocked. Not every Slocum's Joe has a massive tunnel complex underneath it. You're entering a secret Defense Intelligence Agency research lab, a place that never officially existed. It's called the Switchboard. The prototype is locked up in the heart of the facility. If we make it out of here alive, I guarantee your railroad material.
There you are. Movement detected. A regrettable no. An enemy may be utilizing stealth. How interesting.
Hostile sensor reading detected. Warned must die now.
Something for you?
Think you can unlock that terminal?
Count on it. giving you trouble, I could give that terminal a look.
Heads up.
Now, see what I can do.
See what you can do.
Good plan.
Through.
someone managed to close the security door in time. Carrington's prototype is in there. Where's that play button? Oh, it says me.
Excuse me.
I didn't think I'd ever see this place again.
There's an elevator at the end of the hall. It should be a hell of a lot easier fighting chrome domes on this side of the minefield. End of the line. Power up the elevator.
Hostile sensor reading detected. By order of the Institute, you must be destroyed.
Sustaining damage.
Please stand still. Ah!
got what we came for. Let's split up and meet back in the catacombs.
Folks, time for some news. Though, actually, this time it's more addressing some rumors. I'm sure many of you have heard tales of the Railroad, a group working for free synths who are trying to escape the Institute. While it's impossible to say for sure, they may actually be out there. If so, makes sense that they're keeping a low profile. It's a dangerous idea and is met by some very mixed reactions around the Commonwealth. I guess if you are out there, good luck not getting caught. Now, Sheldon Allman wants his girl to crawl out through the fallout.
Days are harder than others, but even the hard days get easier than the one before.
Yeah?
Hey, Carla.
You again. Here to trade?
Let's see what you got.
Here's what I got.
Thank you.
Yes? Life still ain't perfect, but we're surviving.
Take care of your gun. It'll take care of you. All I know is that Dez authorized the op. I just hope we didn't go through all that for the new coffee maker. See you soon. And the new girl patched me up, put me on her shoulder, and blasted her way through the rest of the complex. Synths everywhere.
Carrying you the whole time?
Amazing, right?
That's one word for it. Deacon told me you single-handedly secured Carrington's prototype, disabled a minefield, and wiped out 100 Gen 1s. So is any of that true?
We got the job done. Does the rest matter?
I suppose not. I was expecting Deacon to grab a full team, including Glory, to secure that prototype. But instead, just the two of you cleared out the entire switchboard.
You'd be insane not to sign her up, Dez.
You've certainly made an impression on Deacon. He's never spoken about, or lied about, anyone so highly before. Welcome to the Railroad, Agent.
I'm not sure if I want to join.
If you join us, you'll be putting yourself at great risk. We don't want anyone having regrets later. So I need a yes or no.
I'm not sure if I want to join.
If you join us, you'll be putting yourself at great...
Right? I'm not interested in joining right now.
Understood. The offer is still open, though.
Desdemona.
After what you did at Switchboard, you have a...
Glad to be aboard.
It seems we're very lucky to have you. So you're in. Now we need to know what to call you. Secrecy keeps...
Right. Have any suggestions?
No. It doesn't work like that. Your life, your name, your choice.
Call me... Whisper.
After Tommy? Or... Either way... That's very fitting. Your first official order is to deliver Dr. Carrington his prototype and see if he can use another pair of hands. But first, it's time to meet the rest of the gang. The location of our HQ is one of our most tightly guarded secrets. So be careful coming in or out. You never can tell when you're being watched.
I'm getting tired of waiting.
Another day in the Commonwealth.
Hey!
Everything okay, boy? Come on, boy. It's time to go.
Hey. Hey.